I had a person do my presentation. I started out with the process work for the cat. And he's one of the main characters, and I thought I would give him the most detail. So I just started out with different brute concepts. I put some ears and a tail on them. I chose this last brute because it just looks the best and modified it right here. It's my final one. Here's the mill worker's youngest son, who is the owner of Puss in Boots. He's really poor, so I gave him raggedy clothes that are all stitched up and stuff. I didn't like his hair, so I worked on that a little bit later. After that, I gave Puss in Boots a nose right here to give his face a little texture, and a white belly, just so he's more detailed. And I put some hair texture on the sun, some background with the house that I lived in. And this comes to my first final scene with the windmill and trees. I started with the king in the second scene. I just started out with a really basic shape right here, and then experimented with other shapes. I liked the shape of his crown because it looks really masculine. So I went with this shape right here because this looks more like a dress and kind of like that. So finally I gave him a little cape thing to show that he's more of a royalty and put some more work into his crown and jewels and stuff. And next I did his daughter I gave her some textured hair and stuff. She's a pretty basic character. Well, I gave her a concert. And in this scene, the mill worker's son, he was bathing in a lake. They're on a bridge right now. I tried my best to show that. And here's the final scene with the forest in the background. This is the lake right here. The king gives the mill worker's son some extra clothes because he was bathing and lost his. And we have Puss in Boots way in the back here because he's behind all this. In the final scene, this is when the two of them get married. I just started out with an easy scene. They're in a castle, the king's castle, so I put some bricks up on the walls and banners. I didn't really like the banners too much, so I tried out different types of them, and I still didn't like that too much, so I went with this one, because it just looks better to me, but I made them having hold hands because they're getting married, so. And this is the third final scene with Puss in Boots in the corner with the little mouse that the ogre turned into. It's kind of weird. I tried to make him eat it, but that looked weird. So, final slides.
Slides order view for us. You can use the slider down at the bottom of the screen, you see that, and kind of adjust in between. There you go.
What made you decide not to use faces?
Faces? I didn't really think they needed to like have expressions because I kind of like told what there was going on with the gestures they were using and stuff. Like, I mean, I put a nose on the cat because it looked kind of better. That's kind of bad. So more.
Why do some people have horns and some people don't?
Well, I only used the millworker's son using horns because he was either holding hands with the princess or receiving clothes, but in the first one, I just thought it looked better because he was showing like how raggedy his clothes were with sleeves and stuff. With the cat, I didn't really think he needed arms because he was standing up on his two legs.
Other people?
I was gonna ask, what made you choose the tan and the like pale green colors?
Well, I like the green because it's more of a neutral color than a darker, really bright green. And two of my three scenes are outside, so it kind of depicts nature more. And for the tan, I just thought it looked good because I pictured Puss in Boots to be a tan cat and like people with tan faces. I probably could have gone with a different color, but just like those the most.
Why did you give the princess the same like body structure as the prince? Like, why didn't you do like a dress?
It's a good question. I made her like somewhat smaller than the king and the millworker's son, but I don't know. I could have given her a dress.
Yeah, I think so. Can you just scroll up just slightly so we can see the next row above you, above what we're seeing? Now, there you told us you didn't like the banner before, so you added the swag in the middle of the banners. But on the final one down here, it looks like it's not the same final. See what I'm saying?
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, it looks like you should. But nevertheless, let me just go on, because it's not really important at this moment that you answer about that or anything. But what you seem to be doing in that last one is looking for details you could put in. And this happens a lot of times. You really need to look at how you can bump up the actual characters themselves, more than worrying about brickwork or banners or what have you. Actually, I like it better without the swag though, because you can see the tops of their heads better. When his crown blended into the swag, it just didn't work that well, I don't think. But one, yeah, I think that maybe she should look a little less like him. The ponytail helps, but
yeah.
Guys do wear ponytails too. And yeah, I know you're going to say some guys wear dresses, but it probably would be best here to just put her in a dress and distinguish there. But the most important thing, when you get to the end of that, look how your cat is fading away there. And it's hard for us to distinguish that really is the mouse down there. And you're saying, well, I thought about putting it in his mouth, which would have been cute, but you didn't. But what might be needed is maybe, since he was the star of the whole thing, maybe the cat needed to be enlarged so that he's closer to us in the frame, because he's created the whole event that's behind him, really. And then you might be able to create a way to put the mouse in his mouth, you know? If he were big, right now it's hard to do because the cat himself is tiny. And because he doesn't have an outline, and I'm not saying he has to, but because he doesn't have an outline, it's harder to see him. He's fading, and it's nice we have the happy couple there, but man, the guy who did the whole show needs more attention, see what I mean?
Yeah.
So I mean, rather than worrying about something like the swag, I would make that cat much more prominent there. And I think it wouldn't take much to put a dress on the princess there. Other questions or comments about that or suggestions? Another way to make the mouse sun, you know, stand out there too would be to somehow get some green behind him, you know, maybe extend the green they're standing on or whatever. But I do think that the best way would be to make the mouse considerably more prominent, as though he were standing much closer to us. Other questions and comments, things you've seen in the other scenes, maybe?
I just really like the colors.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, despite the fact that the poor ogre loses his property and deception's going on and that sort of stuff, this isn't one of these horror of horror stories. And it's nice to have some comforting colors there. And this isn't one of these things like somebody's wandering around blind in a forest trying to find, you know, his wife and kids, or his lover and her twins. This is kind of a happy story throughout. You kind of have the feeling that as bright as this cat is and as much power as he's displayed, you could still go up and scratch his ears and chuck him under the chin or something. He was a pretty friendly cat. He wasn't anything ferocious. But what about the other two scenes? Do you have any more comments there?
In the first scene, you have like the grass like green, but then in the second one, it's white. I don't know, why did you choose to change it, I guess?
Well, with all the green in the trees, I thought it would be kind of hard to tell the difference. Yeah. I mean, I could have outlined the trees with black or something to make them stand out, but I tried it and it looked really weird, but it'll just look too congested with all the colors.
On the bridge scene, like the water down there, I think you could maybe do something with that, like maybe have it receding more or coming like under the bridge instead of just that circle.
Yeah. I didn't pay too much attention to the water. Just I tried making more textures with like waving lines and stuff.
But maybe there's another answer there. You don't necessarily want to get that very crowded, but perhaps the shape of it doesn't have to be exactly what it is. And some small wavy lines might do to signify water to some extent. It doesn't, I agree right now, when you first look at it, it almost looks like it's some sort of a call-out signal or something. It doesn't register right away that it's water. And I do think that could use some attention. Anybody else has? No? Well, thank you very much, ma'am.